These digesters are digesters that we call the hybrid type of biodigesters. And the background is simply because you are doing a biodigester for a client at the location. And then after the assessment, you come to the realization that you are going to use prefabricated slabs. And then the slab that you are going to use is only 2 feet. The only option left for you is to have a block work done at the base of the digester before erecting or placing the slabs on it, which will give you a level to get the gradient and then the final outlook of the house to match with it. So in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to go about that. After getting your level of feet, we place the block flat on their back, and then we use the mortar to shape them up. The understanding is that you don't have to do the groundwork specs. Get the level right, and then the type of soil that we met here is also clay. The type of soil we met here is not really clay, but for us, we know we are going to connect it to a stroke away, so it's not going to be a problem. So this is us putting the slabs on the blocks. We are only looking for the elevation because of the gradient, because of the inlet pipe that's coming out. You also don't want the digester to show too much, because then probably when the groundwork is done, it might not match it. So in that case, after agreeing with the technical team, we said that, okay, this level is okay. One cost block is okay. And then we'll put the slabs, the prefabricated slabs. The long side, these are 6 feet slabs, and they are commercial. I mean, they are really, really large biodigesters, and they can be used for commercial purposes. And then we lay the blocks on their back to make sure that the level and the measurement fits right. It's key for you. You need to know the size of the slabs that you are using in this situation. And then you need to adjust the spaces to make sure that you meet it at the right level. Measurement is key. That's why when you come to buy digesters, we always talk about measurement. Measurement is key for you. You need to know measurement to be technically inclined. Whether you know the measurement in feet or you know it in meters, it doesn't really matter. The conversion is available. You can use your phone to do the conversion, and then you are good to go. So what the constructor is doing is he realized that the space is not enough, so he needs to level it up and get enough space to lay the blocks, also leaving enough room for the wastewater to seep out slowly, or either rapidly or slowly depending on the type that you are constructing, into the soak pit or the soak away. That's very key for you in this situation. So this biodigester, we are putting them on the 6 inches blocks. I mean, they are going down for the digester to be, the prefabricated slabs to be erected on them. We are putting the blocks flat so that it can be firm, and then it will not move, it will not shake. If the final groundworks are done with grinding and all this, I think we need that happening when homeowners are finally doing the groundworks for their building or the compound. Some people usually will want to do concrete work. Others prefer to do the tiling. Better so you can tell, some people prefer to tile some part of the compound and then have some vegetation and flowers or some other parts. So depending on what the homeowner is going to do, you should make sure you have done your work to the best satisfaction of the system that you are building, so that whatever they choose to do, it does not affect your work. So they are being held firmly together by the binding wires. And when you do construct, when you do cast the prefabricated slabs or the slabs, make sure you have the binding wires there, because that's what will hold it firmly together in place before you can use the mortar to hold the joints, and then they can come in place firmly. He is checking, the technical guy, the constructor is checking to make sure that all the angles are right, and that you do this one because you don't want the top slab to come and then some parts will be falling in later, or some of the slabs will come off easily after any activity in the compound. So you make sure you check your measurements, use your angle bars, and then you check all the corners to make sure they are firmly tight. You want your digester to be airtight as well. You don't want any spaces there for any water to seep into it. And then for any outside material to also go into the biodigester. He's using the cutter to trim the binding wires and make sure that he kind of screwed them tightly together, leaving no holes or no space in between the slabs. These type of biodigesters are basically for human waste treatment. We have spoken about how they work in such a way that there is a rapid separation of the human waste from the wastewater, which is a sharp different to the traditional ways of human waste management that we have come to know in our part of the world. So this separation is basically to allow you to use the materials that you are going to put in this digester to work well in terms of biodegrading the human waste for easy disposal at a later date. So he's using the mortar to hold the digester slabs tight and to make sure that they do not move around. When you are at this stage, you will need to be very careful. You need to make sure your digester is held firmly together and the mortar has to be in the right mixture that will hold the digester to the blocks. We usually call them the hybrid type of biodigesters. So this is the outlet that we are doing, the outlet for the wastewater. It will be leading to the so-called pit, and then the shape pipe was going to be there. This is the inlet. It's doing the inlet, getting it open, and it's going to take out the wire mesh out. Make sure you do it gently if you are using the slabs. If you are using blocks, obviously, then there's also the same mindset. You have to use a chisel to get that space down. And then your inlet pipe is going to go to this particular. So the level that we are getting is because the pipes are coming from the back and there's some coming from the right side of the digester as well. There's most of them are coming from the other side, and then the building or the compound is slope. The slope is towards the last end. So the reason we are sizing the digester at the lower end is because then it's easy for the plumber to lay all his pipes to this side of the compound of the property. It makes it easier for gradient work, makes it easier for sloping, and then it makes it easier for letting the wastewater out of the digester bed through the leachate pipe and then the soak away. The biodigester works in such a way that you have to get the sloping done when you are doing the screeding on the ground. The screeding must be done at a level. We talk about rapid separation or rapidly letting the water out, but we also don't want it too rapid. We don't want the sharp slope. We prefer a level gradient that will slowly seep the water out, because the mindset or the experience also says that toilet water is the only water that's coming, or the water from the water closet is the only water that is coming into the biodigester. We are not adding kitchen wastewater. We are not adding the bathroom. We are not adding the sink for the brushing of teeth or washing of face or washing of hand. So we can manage the water based on the number of toilet seats or the capacity of the users of the facility. So those are some of the few questions that we ask whenever we are going to construct the biodigester. We want to know the number of rooms, the number of toilet seats. We'd like to know the type of building. Is it a semi-detached? Is it a duplex? An apartment? Is it a complex? What type of facility is it? Then we kind of piece or construct the digesters for that particular users, average users that we envisage will be using the facility. So the screening is being done at the same time as the porous slabs have been laid on the ground. We are using the porous slabs in this case because we want extra enhancement. We want the filtrated water to look more cleaner. And then we want the water to be, it should be good. It should be good for dropping them into the soak pit or soak away. Because then sometimes you do get some clients who want to use this wastewater for other purposes like gardening or watering some of their plants that they are going to have in the compound. So you have to make sure the filtration is done right. Sometimes you include charcoal in it, depending on what kind of water that is going to be used. And then you do it. So basically what you do right here now is porous slab is bigger. It's bigger than the size. Sometimes the measurement doesn't work. When you are casting them, they do spread out and they become bigger. So it's cutting them to size, to fit the size of the digester before laying them in the digester bed nicely. Make sure you don't break them, because if they do break, then it's going to have an effect on the digester bed when the load starts coming on it. How to construct the biodigester is what we are doing. We are watching. This one is about a hybrid type of biodigester where we put the slabs on blocks that we have put on the ground, and then we put the biodigester guiding them.
It's the passing.
So the biodigester filtration bed is what is being laid. It's all being put together nicely. And then the soak away or the pipe, the shape pipe, will show up there, and then it will be part of the whole construction that we are doing. In this particular construction, what we did was to do the biodigester first and then leave the outlet there. At a later date, we're going to come and do the soak away for the digester. We are going to construct a traditional soak away. We are going to use blocks to have it done. And then I've done some videos that shows you why we prefer homeowners spend extra money to do the traditional soak away. It gives you an added advantage in terms of the long use of your biodigester. It enhances the quality of work. It gives you guarantee. It gives us also guarantee, knowing that if there's any issue that we have to deal with, we know exactly where to go. Unlike the so-called pit that when you do them, it's difficult to go back to them and open them and have any assessment done, whether it's working or it's not working. For the soak away, you are going to have top slab on it, a clean out, an access chamber on it. All these things give you enough access to it for you to open it and see if the wastewater is coming from the digester into it. If you are having problems with your biodigester and you have an access to the soak away and you open the soak away and you see that there's no water in it, you know where the problem is.
Solve that problem, then most of the problem will have been solved by then.
Because if there's soak away and there's no water in it, it means that the digester bed has been blocked, and then the leche pipe, either there are some materials in the leche pipe and it's not coming through for the water to come. So naturally, the digester bed will be filled up with water. So the first key point for us right now when we do construct biodigesters, and then we do get a soak away for them, in case you do call us, there's a problem or there's an issue in the call us, the first point is we go straight to the soak away, open it up and see if there's any water there. In another scenario, if you open the soak away and you realize that there's water there, and the water is what is returning back into the biodigester, then the advice is simple to what? Have that water sipped out or pumped out. If the water from the soak away is pumped out or is sipped out, any water in the digester will naturally go back to the soak away. Then the digester will work well. So the fiber net, and then other things were put on the digester bed. This is the fiber, coconut fiber that you are seeing. This one is going to help with the biodegradation. We're going to make sure that the human waste is biodegraded by the use of microorganisms and enzymes that will be generated by this system.
by digester is almost that you are making sure you are putting enough fiber, coconut fiber on it. Make sure all the angles, all the sides do have some. The inlet pipe is also being fixed. The inlet pipe is solely, most of the time, done for the plumber to bring the pipes from the house, come and then have it connected to the biodigester pipe. Make sure the slope is right, which is key. You don't want any human waste to get stuck in the inlet pipe to return back, and the scent and smell will just go back and affect the homeowner if the plumbing work is not done right. Now we have the top covers going on it. The top covers will have to be matched to the slabs. Depending on the number that you have, but the sizes can be 3, it can be 2. You fit them nicely on them, and then you are going to have to sew them airtight. You don't need any vent pipe on a biodigester. I've done videos severally explaining why people do not need vent pipes on the biodigesters. If there's an issue of scent, there must be a vent pipe on the building itself. If you are constructing or you are building your house, ensure the plumber has got a vent pipe on the building. The vent pipes are ideally or usually made for the toilet seats, so that any toilets that get stuck in it, it takes the scent away all the way out. If a biodigester is constructed wall, there is not going to be any scent coming out from the biodigester. So the top slats have been put on it. We are also leaving room for an inspection chamber by putting the clean out on it, so that the homeowner can have access to it. He can open it and see if he's in doubt whether the digester is working or is not working. So I also advise some of my clients that if you are using your property and then you say you're having scent in the house, the question I ask is, do you have a clean out on the digester? Go open it. If you open it and you hear any scent from there, I'll come and do the correction for you. But if you open it and you're not hearing any scent from the biodigester, then the scent that you're hearing from the room or the smell is not from the biodigester. It is from the building or the pipes that were not done. So this is a digging for the soakaway, the traditional soakaway itself being done. And we are going to lay the blocks for that one as well. The understanding here is that if the digester bed or the biodigester is 3 feet, the soakaway must be such that the gradient or the leche pipe, as it's been connected here, goes into it. And there's a room. There's enough room for the water to come. We are leaving spaces inside the soakaway for the wastewater to what? Seep out into the earth surface. Any excess one can be retained in it. And if the ground is even a waterlogged area, then you can put a pump on it and have the water pumped out during the rainy season. During the dry season, the water will always seep out because it's only toilet water you are managing at this point in time. There's no kitchen water. So this is the biodigester plus the soakaway, traditional soakaway that have been done for this particular property. Biodigester construction, after doing a few of them and then realizing that you have to raise the biodigester from the bed, and then you don't want it to disappear completely, because when the groundworks are done, it's possible that the digester will be lost. And you don't want your digester to get lost. You want your digester to be seen in a house. When you show up in the compound for maintenance or to go and do any correction, you want to see your digester showing at the place. If not the complete digester, at least some parts, the top slab or something should be showing, just to let you know that my digester is here.